Hello party people, welcome to a new game of the day. This one is another Sicilian Defense game in our series. And it's another Robert James Fischer game. This one Fischer has the black pieces and he plays against Bilek with the white pieces. And the reason I wanted to show you this game is that Fischer liked to play the poison pawn variation that you will see here in this variation in this game, and the reason for it was because if you play it, this variation, you have to be very sure on what you're doing. You have to know the variations, and if you are very confident and you think that you are very good at the defending, then the poison pawn is a good weapon. And this is the reason because Fischer liked to play it, because he knew that he was stronger, and if you are a strong player and you want to win, you have to go for this complicated lines. And this is the reason why he liked to play the Njadov, why he liked to play the poison pawn variations with black, because he wanted to win, and this is what we see here. So, as I said, here we see with a6 we see the Njadov variation, and Bilek white played bishop to g5, e6 by Fischer, f4, and we see Fischer plays queen to b6, attacking the b2 pawn and going for the poison pawn variation. The idea is that, okay, you as white, you give up the pawn on b2, but at the same time you will have a lead in development, you will have a tempo, you will attack the queen, and at the end of the day the queen is a little bit off from where the action is, and okay, you try to work with that. Okay, here white accepts, he plays queen to d5, queen to d2, and Fischer took on b2. And now here white plays a rather dubious pawn sacrifice. He plays e5, and the idea is that after taking, he plays bishop to c4, and the idea is to attack here the e6 pawn. I mean, if you look at the position, you have like two pieces attacking e6. You have the king ready to castle short, then you would have another piece in the attack. Maybe against a weaker player this would be sufficient, but against Fischer this is not really a good strategy. Black plays e7, and white goes ahead. He sacrifices his bishop on e6. Notice that, I mean, here Fischer castles, which is the right move. Notice that you can't really take. If you take, let's say you take on, here you take on e6, then white here has a strong attack. He can, you know, it's c7 is threatening, and bishop is attacked, and he can castle. This is basically, after this moves, this is a forced draw. Here, white can force a draw. So this is what Fischer did not want. And after, if you take here, this would be another variation. Then you can basically sacrifice your bishop on f7. And after castling, you also get a draw. So these are all like drawish positions if you take, but Fischer had no interest. He just castled, keeping the position alive. And yeah, white castles too, you know, he wants to get more pieces into the attack, not minding this. Okay, now black can take, yeah, but then white has bishop to knight to f5 with a strong attack. So Fischer realized that he has to dislocate the queen, because the queen here is very strong, eyeing down on the g-line. So this is the reason why he played h6. And this is very cold-blooded defense. But you have no other choice, because otherwise you will get checkmated. White here plays a rather dubious move. He plays queen to h4. A better move would have been queen to d2. Black would still have been better, but then you would have a somehow reasonable position. Okay, he played his queen to h4. Black just took, as I said, a cold-blooded defense. And okay, here white just tries to muddy the water a little bit. This is like a complete raging attack, and you are basically here as black, you have two choices. You rather find the best moves, or you lose. Again, against a weaker player, this might have been a good strategy, but against Fischer, it's basically hopeless. Okay, white tries to attack, and this, on the first glance, it looks dangerous. No? White plays bishop to f7, dragging the king out, and okay, I mean here, black's pieces are all undeveloped. No? You might think, okay, this is something, but you have sacrificed a lot of pieces, and yeah, now it's up to you to prove it. And here's a funny thing. The problem is that white already, or yeah, when black with Fischer already analyzed his position. I mean, Fischer was known for his extremely strong homework. He was very good at preparing and studying and analyzing. And here, up to this point, Fischer basically had only spent 5 minutes. This is incredible. And his opponent already spent something over 2 hours. So now we are entering time trouble territory. Okay, and again, as white, you have to prove that you can checkmate here. But now black is having the initiative. And okay, black tried, or black played queen to c2. He wants to basically capture all the pawns here. And what do you do as white? Your attack is going nowhere. Funny enough, this position here after queen to f2 is equal. Yeah, but now time trouble comes into play. And here white made the losing move. He played rook to f3. I've forgotten the best move here for white. Let me see. Okay, your h3 was the best move, so that you can get your knight out and protect e5. But after this one here, black's king is in safety, and here black's white's flag fall. He lost on time. Yeah, but basically he has achieved nothing. He sacrificed a pawn in the opening and is still down a pawn if you believe the engine. So yeah, I wanted to show you this game. I mean, because if you an attack on the king is not something that always succeeds in the Sicilian, but you have to know what you are doing, and if you are sure that you can defend and go for it, yeah. Okay, thank you much, bye bye.